your awareness will be awakened. If your awareness is awakened, you can work on that energy center. It's a highly mystical energy center which can give spiritual experience even in one single session of meditation. A single session of meditation, deep meditation on this chakra, can give you awareness, can give you experience. You don't need to do continuously. Of course, doing continuously is good. Even a single session can give you wonderful experiences. Any questions? Then we will enter into meditation.
Can somebody get enlightenment just by doing meditation on this chakra?
Yes. This chakra is capable of that. This single chakra can directly lead you, and actually, according to me, this chakra is straight to the enlightenment. With other chakras, for example, if you create energy in Manipuraga, 20% will be used for physical health, 30% will be used for mental health, then remaining 50 will go for spiritual well-being. Every chakra has got their own 2-3 links. But this chakra, no question of bothering about body or mind, straight to the enlightenment. It never heals the body or heals the mind. Straight to the enlightenment. No energy is wasted. No, physical injury never does much to it. Except Mooladhara. Only Mooladhara physical injury does a little bit role in that. Otherwise, no chakra can be disturbed by physical injury. People ask me, I underwent bypass surgery, will Anahata be there as it is? It will be there as it is, don't worry. Whether you undergo bypass surgery or open heart surgery, Anahata chakra will be there. But when the masters touch that area, the chakra can be awakened. The touch of the master is so powerful, even physically touching, if a master touches, the chakra will be awakened.
Many gurus, there was a big, the new age, they all wanted Shakti Bath right away, coming to get the Shakti Bath, and all, everyone was offering that, and, and the real authentic gurus were always saying, if I heal your leg today, you're going to break it tomorrow. No, I mean, if I heal your broken leg today, you'll break it. You have to still break it in another time. So I'm wondering, your willingness to do something which maybe is similar to that, to Shakti Bath, is what I'm thinking.
One thing.
Your willingness is because of the dire earth need of the times.
Mm-hmm. Okay. One thing. It is out of the compassion of the masters the energy expresses in the form of healing. Healing your leg or healing your thing. Even if you again tomorrow break, I'll be there again to heal you, don't worry. That is what is the compassion.
But you're being here and doing this in mass is kind of because of the urgency of the times.
Not only urgency of the time, it is time to save the planet Earth.
That's what I'm
Otherwise, the collective negativity is going too much. Too much, it is crossing. That's the reason masters come all out. They come all out. And one more thing, it is not even the decision of a master, it is the decision of the energy. Once you become enlightened, you can't even decide, should I keep quiet and stay in one place or should I go around the planet Earth and do? Nothing will be decided by you. Simply it will start happening. I never wanted to come to Seattle. This time I did not give date to Seattle. These 4 dates is supposed to be for London. And then we decided cancel London, we will have a rest. But somehow I landed up. I'm here. That is the way it usually happens. our guys are planning at least for last 1.5 years that they wanted to give me 1 week rest. The day we started the ashram, from that day to till today, they are planning to give at least a week rest. Ask them, are they able to be successful? Are they able to be successful? For last 1.5 years, my routine is there in the website. If you go to the website, you can see last 1.5 years routine without even 1 day break. Appearing somewhere or other in public. Things are happening. So you don't even, you have no will. It's not that you will possess enlightenment and sell if you want and open it and close the door, nothing. Enlightenment will possess you.
And you surrender.
Simply, you will do what has to be done. Nothing can be done. You can't do anything. Maybe, see, the deep search, deep seeking is a low pressure. Naturally, cyclone has to come there. Naturally, it starts happening.
So, you said enlightened masters, do they communicate among themselves?
Naturally. There is no need even to communicate. It is called communion. Not even a communication, it's not even a verbal, it is just an energy level. You see, understand this kerchief as cosmic energy or the universal layer. And there is one small thread in this corner, that is what is Nityananda. And here one thread, different masters are hanging threads. Like a thread hanging in this kerchief. Like a thread hanging in the kerchief. When somebody calls somewhere, immediately people come and tell me, Swamiji, I saw you in the darshan, I saw you in the vision, will you know when you give me darshan? I tell them, actually when you get darshan or vision, this thread Nityananda, you see the cosmic Nityananda is the universe, the enlightened one, person. Which is the whole universe or universal energy. This thread is the Nityananda with whom you are sitting. This Nityananda can download the information from cosmic Nityananda. When you had the darshan, what happened? What I told you. Those things can be downloaded and brought into this form. That's all. Wherever you call, in whichever form, the same energy only comes down and gives you darshan. You ask Rama or Krishna or Baba or Jesus or Buddha or any master, the same energy only comes down and blesses you. You just put 911, any cop will appear. Just put that. Ask any master. All same energy only. In that form, it will appear and bless you. If you ask in the form of Krishna, Krishna will appear. If you ask in the form of Rama, Rama will appear. But any enlightened master can download that information and tell you. That's all. In any form, it can be downloaded. Just a very touch of an enlightened master in the life does tremendous transformations. It does tremendous transformations. Any other questions?
The universal energy, does it guide your life? Universal energy, does it?
No, I am not different from it. So that there is no question of even guiding and being guided. It happens.
So the guide our life.
Yes.
It does too.
Surely. When you try to connect yourself with that energy, it guides you.
If we're not connected, we would not guide.
Of course. Naturally, when you don't want, it gives you the freedom to suffer. It gives you the freedom to be in bondage. Techniques are independent of me. Now in this technique, you are going to directly relate with me. So, I wanted all of you to sit around. People who have got specs, eye problem, they can come forward because this will directly heal the eyes. Let me give the instruction. Please listen. We are going to work in two ways. One is by opening the eyes and another one is closing the eyes. First, you will work by closing your eyes. When you work by closing your eyes, you will visualize as if you are drilling your third eye from inside to outside. Understand? Not from this way, from this way. Outside, inside to outside. You will visualize as if you are drilling it, so that the whole energy will be concentrated on it. When I say open your eyes, look through your third eye. This is very tricky. When you open your eyes, don't think you are looking through these two eyes. Think, strongly suggest, I am looking through third eye. Automatically the eyes will get inserted, that you don't bother. You don't try to insert. You just visualize, I am looking through this area.
So how is the first way again?
First, when you close your eyes, you will feel that you are penetrating your third eye. Yes. You will concentrate on that area and feel that you are drilling it from inside to outside.
Well, then that's the same as the other way, isn't it? Isn't that the same way as with the eyes open?
Yeah.
Inside out?
Mm.
Through this third eye.
See, when you close your eyes, when you close your eyes, you will concentrate on this area and visualize you are drilling it from inside to outside. Okay?
Well, that's the way I heard you say both ways. Both of them seem to mean the same.
No.
Okay, so which one is looking from the inside out, this third eye?
Yourself.
My eyes are closed. Okay.
You will visualize you are penetrating from inside to outside, your third eye.
Yeah, when your eyes are closed.
Closed.
And when you're open.
When you open, you will look through your third eye to my third eye.
Oh. Oh.
Yes, to my third eye. So, when you close your eyes, you will penetrate your third eye. When you open your eyes, you will penetrate through your third eye, my third eye. Okay? Whenever any thought raises, don't bother, surrender it. Just surrender all the thoughts. In a relaxed way, if you look at a rose flower or a child, how relaxed way you gaze and enjoy. Just like that. Gaze in a relaxed way. Don't create tension. In a relaxed way, penetrate my third eye. Okay?
The two eyes,
can you? Yes. When I say open your eyes, you will open the two eyes, but you will visualize that you are looking through third eye. Any other?
And the first way again.
Doubt.
What's the first way again? I'll scratch it up.
First way, you close your eyes and visualize you are drilling your third eye from outside to inside, from inside to outside. Second thing, you open your eyes and look through your third eye to my third eye.
Oh, okay.
Again and again, two, three times we will be doing it.